I don't know about you, but nowadays when I see a headline like this one, talking about an 800-mile range electric vehicle powered by a revolutionary solid-state battery, I experience a sense of very slight scepticism. The first video on this channel that mentioned solid-state batteries for electric vehicles was way back in 2018, when a naive, fresh-faced young presenter made this earth-shattering prophecy.
Graphene, sodium ion, supercapacitors, ultracapacitors, and solid-state batteries. And it's the last of these solid-state batteries that look like becoming a commercially viable product, maybe even as early as 2020.
Now, to be fair, we did have a global pandemic in 2020, didn't we? So we can perhaps give the solid-state developers a year or maybe even 18 months or so of grace. But given the fact that since then we've been fed an almost weekly stream of pronouncements from battery makers and auto manufacturers all over the world that their particular solid-state technology will be in a real-world production vehicle in just a few months' time, we could, I think, be forgiven for being a little bit disappointed and disillusioned as we reach the back end of 2025, with none of those promises so far having been proven to be remotely accurate. There is furious activity going on in the sector, though. We've got firms in China and South Korea all at it. And after years of bad-mouthing electric batteries and barking up the bonkers tree of hydrogen fuel cells, even the Japanese behemoth Toyota now claims it's about to ride into the solid-state battery fray like a knight in shining armour. European giants are also having a go. Volkswagen, for example, has been spreading its bets by working hard with US firm QuantumScape and Chinese firm Gotion to get solid-state batteries into their next-generation vehicles. So surely one of them must be close, right? Hello, and welcome to Just Have a Think. I imagine you know the spiel quite well by now, don't you? Solid-state batteries are the next big thing that will transform electric vehicles with much higher range, faster charging times, less fire risk, and lighter weight. They achieve all that apparently all-conquering array of parameters because unlike a normal lithium-ion battery that uses a highly flammable liquid or gel electrolyte between an anode and a cathode, a solid-state battery replaces the liquid with a solid electrolyte that takes up far less space and is not made from a flammable material. But the annoying concept known as the Valley of Death has proven to be a far wider leap than most developers had hoped for. The materials are new and complex, manufacturing yield is low, costs are high, and scaling from lab to gigawatt-hour production has proven to be very difficult. So the plan today is to have a quick scoot through the major players, including Cherry with their 800-mile range claim, to see who's closest to the winning line and when we might really, really be able to buy an electric vehicle with an all-solid-state battery. Before we do that, though, it's time for another shameless appeal to your good nature. On average, about 40% of you folks out there watching this video are not subscribed to the channel. As a one-man band operator doing all the research and writing and animating, editing and final production myself, I don't have big teams of bright young things to grease the wheels of channel growth. I rely solely on you, hopefully enjoying my content and considering me worthy of your recognition. Now, of course, if you don't think I'm worthy, then by all means keep watching anyway. But if you haven't yet clicked that all-important little button and you feel you could do, then you would really be making my day. Now, we'll come back to Cherry's latest breakthrough claim a bit later in the video, but let's start with good old VW and their partners in China and the USA. As recently as October 2025, Chinese firm Gotion announced that its all-solid-state Jinsi battery has entered pilot-scale production, and the company's begun designing a 2-gigawatt-hour mass production line. Gotion claims a cell energy density of 350 watt-hours per kilogram, which is significantly higher than Tesla's so-called 4680 cylindrical lithium-ion cell, which we'll use as our baseline for the rest of this video. Gotion reckons a full battery pack is good for about 1,000 miles of range, with stable performance between minus 20 and plus 85 degrees Celsius, and a projected lifespan of 1 million kilometres. The company's roadmap suggests small-scale vehicle integration around 2027 and mass production by around 2030. VW is also working with QuantumScape over in the States, perhaps the best known of all the solid-state developers. Their technology centres on what they refer to as a lithium metal anode-free solid-state cell. This tech uses a lithium metal anode that is actually formed in situ during charging. That effectively means there's no pre-existing anode. The solid electrolyte is in fact a ceramic separator, which plays a dual role. It provides a highly conductive pathway for lithium ions, and it physically impedes the growth of the dreaded lithium dendrites that we've looked at plenty of times in previous videos on this channel. The idea is that you get higher energy density, QuantumScape claims just over 300 watt hours per kilogram at cell level, improved safety, faster charging, like 15 minutes to go from 10 to 80%, and potentially longer cycle life. But QuantumScape has gotten itself a bit of a reputation for over-promising and under-delivering, hasn't it? So where are they right now? Well, in Q3 of 2025, the company announced shipments of B1 samples of their so-called QSE5 cell, and they are apparently now installing a highly automated cell production pilot line at their headquarters in California using a new manufacturing process known as COBRA that is claimed to be 25 times more efficient than its predecessor. You may have seen the very recent press coverage of an actual QuantumScape solid-state battery in one of VW's Ducati electric motorcycles. That's encouraging stuff, demonstrating real-world scalability for the technology and the strength of the partnership with the German giant. QuantumScape's timeline for commercialization has now been accelerated, with analysts projecting a commercially viable product by 2027. Keep that year in mind, by the way, because it might come up again and again. So what about the two largest battery manufacturers in the world then, CATL and BYD? Well, CATL has entered trial production of some relatively small all-solid-state battery cells, which they claim to have energy densities of about 500 watt-hours per kilogram, but only as early lab-scale prototypes. So for the purposes of our comparison chart, we probably need to take that with a large pinch of salt. The company's actually been beavering away on this since 2016, and it apparently now has about 1,000 dedicated colleagues working on the challenge. And guess when they say they'll have a production-ready batch of all solid-state batteries? Yep, 2027. In fact, in typical CATL candor, the company says it's currently only at technology readiness level 4, and they themselves caution that despite the 500 watt-hour per kilogram headline number, charging speed, cycle life, cost, yield, and manufacturing scale still remain substantial challenges for them. Their CEO, Robin Zeng, recently publicly stated that he thought ASSBs are still years away from full commercialization. Perhaps unsurprisingly, BYD is in almost exactly the same position. They've had a small-scale prototype line for a year or so now, achieving 400 watt-hours per kilogram. And they too are projecting 2027 as the year when they will launch a demonstration vehicle powered by their all-solid-state battery technology, with full commercial production slated for 2030. The key barrier for both companies seems to be not so much the technology itself, but the challenge of making it cost competitive with their own existing lithium ion and sodium ion chemistries. I certainly wouldn't count them out though. When it comes to delivering on promises, few companies have performed more impressively than these two in recent years. So that brings us to Cherry, not the last manufacturer we'll look at today, but arguably the one with the boldest claim so far. In November 2024, the company announced it had already got a gigawatt hour level all-solid-state battery production line under development in Wuhu in the Anhui province of China. Then in January 2025, the first batch of engineering samples of ASSBs rolled off their production lines with a real-world cell-level energy density of about 300 watt-hours per kilogram. And now they've just unveiled this latest prototype with an astonishing 600 watt-hours per kilogram of gravimetric energy density, which according to the fevered reporting in the Chinese press, makes it good for more than 800 miles or 1300 kilometers of real-world range. But while the first generation 300 watt-hour per kilogram version can be considered a genuinely commercial product, the 600 watt-hour version cannot, at least not yet anyway. Chery Automobile is suggesting a date for large-scale rollout of this one though, and you'll never guess when that date is. Yeah, it's 2027. Who would have predicted that, eh? What a remarkable coincidence. Now, I wouldn't want to upset the sensibilities of the myriad other companies all over the world who would also consider themselves to be in with a decent shout at the all-solid-state battery crown. So while I can't mention every single one, I think it is worth highlighting a few of the other main contenders. Chinese automaker NIO has recently been very vocal about its ET7 sedan, which achieved more than 650 miles on a single charge using cell chemistry from another Chinese firm, WeLion. So first of all, the battery pack was 150 kilowatt hours, which is about 1.5 times the capacity of even the largest EV batteries on the market today. So range is bound to be longer. And secondly, the WeLion cells are not all solid state, they're semi-solid state. So what do I mean by that then? Well, there's a little bit of gel in the semi-solid state battery, which is there to take up the microscopic undulations between two solid materials and overcome the reduction in ionic transfer at the interface of electrode and electrolyte, which has been one of the major challenges of the all-solid state developers. But adding a gel back into the mix adds cost and complexity in production. It means you need dual phase manufacturing, one phase for the dry electrode steps and another phase for the wet filling. You also need more precise sealing systems to prevent leaks and additional QC steps to ensure the gel's distributed just right. Plus you need special handling equipment for high viscosity gels. In other words, many of the things that proper solid state battery developers are trying to avoid. Several other car makers, mostly Chinese, have now jumped on the semi-solid state bandwagon, but it's a hybrid technology at best. It may well have its place for now, but when the all-solid state batteries do eventually arrive, they will most likely spell the end for this stopgap configuration. There's loads of other small-scale battery developers in China, of course, but Farasis is perhaps the best known of the Tier 2 batch. They've got backing from Mercedes-Benz, among others, and they also have a pilot production line up and running, producing their Gen 4 pouch cells with a claimed energy density of 323 watt-hours per kilogram. Then there's Prologium, just across the water in Taiwan. That company is apparently planning a gigafactory in Dunkirk in France for 2027, which seems a bit random. But anyway, their so-called superfluidized, all-inorganic solid-state tech is seen by many as one of the more advanced contenders in terms of cell chemistry, because it kind of steals the idea of a semi-solid state battery in production, but does actually output a genuinely all solid state product. The company achieves that by temporarily fluidizing a ceramic-based solid electrolyte during processing so that it can flow into all those micro crevices we talked about earlier to form an intimate contact between electrode and electrolyte. Then they cool it all down into a solid before the end of the production line. Clever stuff, eh? The latest prototype has a gravimetric energy density of 360 watt-hours per kilogram, and the company reckons it's on the way to 470 watt-hours per kilogram with their next generation version. Other players include SK On, who are a major South Korean battery maker. In September this year, they launched a 50,000 square feet or 4,600 square meter all-solid state pilot plant just outside the South Korean capital, Seoul. They're targeting a cell with a volumetric energy density of 800 watt-hours per litre, which could possibly translate into something like 280 to 300 watt-hours per kilogram of gravimetric energy density by 2029, but worth keeping an eye on nevertheless. So, you know, they're on their way, and it really does now look like they'll be arriving very soon indeed. We're just going to have to be a little bit more patient for a little while longer. That's it for this week. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and you can also directly help keep the lights on around here by joining the heroic group of channel supporters over at patreon.com/justeverthink. Most important of all though, thanks very much for watching. Have a great week, and remember to just have a think. See you next week.